It's a vegetarian poem, but you're all vegetarians already, right? How many non-vegetarians? I want to see. I have to do this thing. That's how we'll do it. That's how it's done. It's called targeting your audience.
I thought you were voting on poems.
What? Yeah, we'll vote on poems, yeah. It's called Naked Brunch. Naked Brunch, Naked Lunch, Naked Hunch, Naked Crunch, rah! God made a mistake, God made a mistake, a sirloin steak, God made a nice steak. And the Lord God gave man, not woman, to have dominion over all the fish in the cans, the foul air, and all crawling things. Eat up your snake or I'll slap you in the mouth. Eat up your toes or I'll smack you in the mouth. Eat up your snails or I'll slash you in the mouth. Eat up your roaches or I'll smash you in the mouth. Bring out your dead. Bring out your dead. Bring out your dead. Naked brunch, naked lunch, naked hunch, hunya, 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 naked crunch, rah. When a man kills a tiger, he calls it sport. When a tiger kills a man, he calls it beast, rah, ferocity. Little lamb, who ate thee? Did the man who planted orchards eat thee? Red in tooth and claw, white of heart and ruth, I ate the dairy man, red of claw and tooth. Daisy, Daisy, give me your dollars due. How you gonna keep 'em down on the farm after they once ranged free? Cage 'em in a factory and don't let 'em move. You'll earn a much tidier fee. Indiana, Montana, I am but your crops. Now it's down in New York City, I hang in your shops. I'm fur for your ladies, I meet for your kids. Once I breathe like you did, but you broke all my ribs. Once I walk God's green earth till you roasted my ribs. Naked brunch, naked lunch, naked hunch. Naked brunch. Recognize the tune. East side, west side, all around the town. People are sleeping on gratings, Brooklyn bridges falling down. Meanwhile, business is booming in Soho and on Brooklyn Heights. Landlords are making a killing. Somehow that word seems just right. Another day, another dollop, what's the big surprise? Developers pack quite a wallop. Flowers are free enterprise. People with blue sky for shelter. People with no place to piss. Washed down Don Trump on his hot yacht. Hey, all right. Oh, Calcutta was better than this. Oh, east side, west side, all around the town. People freezing in subways. Cheap housing just ain't around. Meanwhile, the stock exchange boom zooming. Jack LaLanne is doing all right. Makers making a killing. Somehow that word still seems right. Then look to the feds asleep in their beds. Squatters rousted out. Hoarding apartments for sweet deals. It's what capitalism's all about. Me and the mayor went walking. I heard that racist squawk. Tripping over bodies. Fantastic. On the sidewalk of New York. East side, west side, all around the town. People dying on gratings. Guess the system's falling down.
The no rehearsal band. While they're, are we ready?
Yeah.
Okay. This is called Beloved Enemy. Who will you kill when there's no commies left to kill? Who will you hate when Marx has met his fate? Who will you beat when you beat your meat? Don't worry, be happy. We need an enemy. We need an enemy. We need an enemy. Who will you jail when the junkies all make bail? Who will you jail when we all turn semi-queer? Who will you tease when the blind man sees? Don't worry, be merry. We need an enemy, we need an enemy. Who will you kill when there's no bad blacks left to kill? Who will you shove when pushes come to love? Who will you fight when might has lost its right? Don't worry, be nappy. While you're marrying up the Jews, who will you skin when the wetbacks all get in? Who will you hit when the kids grow up a bit? Don't worry, eat curry. We need an enemy, we need an enemy.
What about an enemy instead of an enemy?
And what will you do when the revolution comes? What will you do when the job is done? What will you sing when the protest's gone? Don't worry, be silent.
I just got an idea for a song against death. You think that would go? I'm going to take 30 seconds for a political statement. It's in the lines of the song. We do have an enemy now, the narco traficantes. You know, cocaine kills 2,000 people a year. Nicotine kills almost 400,000. So I expect the president of Philip Morris, the inventor of the Bill of Rights, to be sort of strung up soon. Bennett said he's for the death penalty for the drug kingpins. one other thought. You know the American soldiers killed in Panama? They were killed by good American guns, good American bullets, and by soldiers trained by good American soldiers. Wow. I think most of you know this song. For those who don't, on the song on which this song is based, I'll give you one line. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must I be a
geezer love?
Very good. I sort of updated it. Ooh, ooh, whoa. Ooh, whoa. Ooh, ooh, whoa. Each time we have some sex, it almost breaks my balls, 'cause I am so afraid we will not come at all. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must I be a septuagenarian in love? One day I feel so horny, next night I feel so blah. Guess we'll have to take the whoopee, whoopee with the bah. Each night I ask the moon up above, why must I be a septuagenarian in love? I try to fuck you, everybody and you. I'll be the hot up one if you all think I'm through. Well, if you want to make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. If you should say fuck off today, I would still whack off to you. Each night I ask Venus up above, why must I be a septuagenarian in love? I'd love to fuck you, everybody plus you. I'll be the lonely one if you say we're through. Well, if you wanna make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. If you should shout, fuck off, go away, I will still whack off to you. Each night I ask the satellite above, why must I be a septuagenarian in love? Why must I be an alta cocker in love? Why must I be a
When someone from Newsweek came down to where the Fugs were playing on McDougal Street, and she seemed so genuinely interested, and she wore sneakers, and very sympathetic, and the story that appeared was a real sort of snide attack on what we were doing and what we stood for. I was young then, now I was young and stupid then, now I'm old and stupid. And the other was a strange visit from someone from TV Weekly. What is it, the one that gives you all those programs? TV Guide. And he started, supposedly it was an interview on the Fugs, I guess. And he started to ask me where certain people were now. And I looked for that article, but it never appeared. He didn't get any information out of me either. Anyway, I just came from a writers' conference held at the beautiful building, the Puck Building, that's now a condominium. And it was sponsored by, let's give him a plug, by a New York writer. What's that phrase, you know? Don't spare the guilty. Anyway, it was, in spite of what they did, there were a few interesting things there, but they did two things. First of all, the magazine is very slick and thick. It has Brigitte Bardot on the cover this month. I had John Lennon last. Brigitte Bardot was all right, but I don't know why they put her on the cover. I guess as one of the century's great writers. And the other thing I want to report is that the admission was $100. Hey. And some people actually pay, not me. I told Sylvia I wouldn't have gone if it was, except it was free and right around the corner. Anyway, I wrote this little piece about, I was reminded by what Mitch said about freedom of speech in America. Paul Goodman said you can say anything you want in America as long as it doesn't have any effect. And so this is about, you know, that's like, if voting could change anything, it would be illegal. This is called At the Writers' Conference. Are you a writer? Yeah, well, I know how to write, don't you? You know what I mean? Yeah. Well, then you're a writer, too. But you know, even we writers, we talk more than we write, so maybe we should be called talkers. Yeah, yeah. And as I said, leaving, as I left, I said, I prefer walkers. Okay, that's just a poem about elitism, I guess. Okay.
The president has the power to destroy a large part of the, what they call the human race. And why should anyone have that power? That's a mistake.
That's right. Nobody's your president.
Oh.
Revolution.
By the way, how much does the president earn every earn a year? Is it used to be $175,000? Did he get a cost of killing increase? No. Anyway, it's not really what he earns in office. You know, it's like the Olympics, where the all the Olympic players. I hate athletics of all kinds, and including sports. Anyway, it's the perks that come afterward. Kissinger got a contract with one of the major networks. Fortunately, you don't see him very often. I think it was for $1.5 million or $2 million. And Nixon keeps writing books. His last book was called 1999. He said he's publishing the book called 1999 now because I want to pass on that experience before I'm too old to articulate it. Nobody will vote. Nobody deserves your vote. Nobody for president. Nobody will clean the water. Nobody will fresh the air. Nobody will spend a quarter to assure the land stays fair. Nobody so wise of heart. Nobody doth never fought. Nobody was blessed with grace to keep us peasants in our place. Nobody plans no disruption on the highway to corruption. And nobody should have the power to destroy us all about half an hour. Every 4 years in this nation, butcher, lawyer, cop, or baker, fools, no matter what their station, get to pick their own dictator. And we all are free to choose him from whatever wing we're free, right or left of the same party, the sleaze party of property, Republicans, Democrats. No one holds the rod of God over you, you poor dumb sod. Chug your beer and sip your toddy, stumble out, vote for nobody. Vote early and vote often. Nobody will tell you straight, when you vote, you abdicate. Find the ways to take your power at home, school, factory, our power. Tweedledum and Tweedledee, nobody will set you free. Tweedledee and Tweedledum, in your own acts, your liberty. Now, having said all that, some of my best friends have voted, and I've got nothing better to do. Can hold your nose and put your hands over your eyes. I don't know. It's up to you. However, if Bush does win, there are some advantages. For instance, I found three. One, Ronald Reagan won't have us to kick around, at least, you know. And Bush might inherit the depression. And we'll finally get rid of the illusion of the Democratic Party. You remember Contragate? The dreams of Watergate came floating back, you know, another impeachment. One, two, three, Watergate's the last was not to be. But during that period, I wrote this song that I'm going to, it's a single song, actually. And house lights. Oh, there are no house lights. What a house.
The garage.
He tells us a story of lying and of murder too. To whom is this tale mystifying? Not to me, boys, perhaps tis to you. They're telling a story of Reagan, a president so bold and so true. How can he be a false killer? Red, white, and blue. Wrapped in the white, red, and blue, boys. Wrapped in the red, white, and blue. A man of the movies, a star. So here's to President Reagan, boys, to Ollie, to Dick, and to Cap, to some your American heroes, to me they're just murderous crap. So here's to Dumbo, run Reagan, boys, to Ollie, to Ford, and to Cap. To some, they're American heroes. To us, they're American crowds. Thank you. This is by Abbie, and it's from Woodstock Nation, 1960, published 1969. He uses the word pigs, not that I sort of think maybe it's an insult to pigs, but I don't think it's an effective word, you know, so I sort of object. It doesn't seem to do any good. It didn't ever work. I mean, they're still pigs. No. It's called Thorns of the Flower Children. Once upon a time, about a generation ago, right after the 30,764th demonstration against the war in Vietnam,
young people started to congregate in an area of San Francisco known as Haight-Ashbury. They were sick of being programmed by an educational system void of excitement, creativity, and sensuality. A system that channels human beings like so many laboratory rats with electrodes rammed up their asses into a highly mechanized maze of class rankings, degrees, careers, neon supermarkets, military-industrial complexes, suburbs, repressed sexuality, hypocrisy, ulcers, and psychoanalysts. The world they came from was a world of doublespeak, a world where Lyndon Johnson and his fabulous wife, Lady Bird, sat in the Miami modern ranch house, drank their bourbon, and led the nation in a marathon game of Scrabble. The victor, naturally, would donate the winnings to his or her favorite charity. My fellow pigs, this land of ours is the most peace-loving nation in the history of the world. This government stands for peace. It does not believe social change can come about through violence. Oink, oink. And then here's a dispatch from Saigon. This is all literal from a paper somewhere. Saigon. Colonel James Rivers, a veteran of World War II, Korea, and now in Vietnam, stated that the American fighting man never had it so good as in Vietnam. Just back from supervising a raid in the Mekong Delta, in which over 5,000 of the enemy were killed in 3 days of heavy fighting, Rivers admitted, "This is the only war in history where the fighting man can sleep in a warm bed, eat a good breakfast, take a helicopter ride to battle, pause for a lunch break, and return to the base in a helicopter in time for supper, and a look at the day's fighting on the evening's telecast." Vietnam is the first commuter war, he explained. That's the close of that dispatch. And when the game was over, Latin America, quote, our partners in progress, quote,